Look at that.
Oh, it's done. Look at that.
It looks magnificent.
Yeah.
Oh, when it sounds awesome. Like that.
It's done.
Matt Germanchis is such a devotee of the wood-fired oven, he insisted they were part of his kitchen at the chic Pay Modern restaurants in Sydney and Melbourne, where he's head chef.
To me, it's raw. It's the essential part of cooking. It gives a totally different texture.
At home, he's happy to become the student when his marvellous grandmother, Christina, is in the kitchen.
Not too much.
Is that enough?
Yeah, it should be enough.
Yep.
The oven at Matt's parents is a wood-burning oven of a different type, an adored Aga, created by a Swedish scientist who devised a clever way to use a small amount of wood to provide heat and cooking.
Tell me what this oven allows you to do.
Most of all, it's flavour.
So if you're going to have a beautiful Greek pie, the best you'll ever have is from a wood-fired oven.
Yeah, without a doubt. Traditionally, it's done like that. Back at home, it's done like that.
So I always start with the hardiest leaves first, which to me is my nettle.
Mm.
And we just let it stew in its own juices.
So you're wilting them?
Yes, exactly. Essentially, horta is really overcooked
greens,
you know? And that's how most Greeks like it, you know?
Yeah.
I call it now my 50 shades of grey. And then we'll start with our spinach. And then we'll add this sorrel. And I tend not to chop the sorrel. And then see how that's nothing else but its own juices just wilting away.
But it's still dangerously green, Matt.
I know. What's going on there? Maybe it's too fresh. So we just need to cool this down. And then we'll make our next stage of the horta. So we're just going to add about 3 tablespoons of really good olive oil. Our cooled down greens. Doesn't have to be super hot. We add our eggs, okay? So just 2 eggs, whisked up, and it can't curdle. We just have to thicken it. Like that. And now we just take it off the heat and we add a little bit of our feta, a sheep's feta, and we can see that it's nice and white.
Now, is that Yaya's recipe?
Of course it's Yaya's recipe.
So each time you stretch it just a little bit further. Isn't it nice? You can have 2 restaurants, but you're still the junior in
definitely.
Your family kitchen.
Without a doubt.
you didn't mix it up, you naughty boy. You can't eat spinach and cheese separate.
Sorry.
You have to eat it together.
Sorry. I won't do it again.
Tell him off again. To the big chef. Today I am the big chef.
Yeah, you are the big chef today. Without doubt.
More cheese on top.
Yep.
No, you're the chef.
This is another technique.
Ah. So you have a ruffled surface.
Right, yeah. Mm.
How beautiful.
Mm. Oh. Do the edges.
Do the edge.
So you're turning and pressing and rolling at the same time.
Yeah. Okay, the butter now. Not too much everywhere. Not too much.
Okay.
Matt, you're back to junior status.
You're working for the restaurant. We can't afford that.
It's
lovely.
Great.
That's ready for cooking.
How long's the pie cooked for, Matt?
This will take about 40 minutes.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, it's done. Look at that.
It looks magnificent.
Yeah,
oh, when it sounds awesome. Like that.
It's done.
Do you think we should just have some of this before we have anything else?
Beautiful.
Perfect.
Flaky.
Flaky, beautiful. Yum. Fantastic. Oh, thanks for sharing your grandmother.
That's all right. That's all right, isn't it?
To you, Christina. To you.